gonna be a good day today. I can feel it. What's up, everybody? This is Motor Merc coming to you from beautiful Southern California on a Motovlogger Fanboy Pilgrimmage. I haven't done a Motovlogger shout-out in a long time because it's been a while since I discovered very many new vloggers. And the vloggers I'm going to talk about today are not actually new. They are quite established in the scene, but they are new to me, and I have become a big fan of theirs. So I think it's worth sharing them with you just on the off chance that maybe you haven't heard of them. These are mostly Southern California motovloggers, and I had always sort of quietly wondered why there weren't more Southern California motovloggers, but it turns out that there are actually plenty of them, and I'm just really bad at finding them. So in no particular order, we have Suburban Delinquent, ArsonRides, and bakerXderek. I think I've talked about bakerXderek before, actually, in my videos, but these guys are just super fun to watch, and I'm jealous of the fun that they have, the hijinks they get into. They just have such magnetic personalities, and they're kind of crass a lot of the time, especially bakerXderek and ArsonRides. They like to do a lot of cursing and bad-mouthing and stuff, but you could tell it's all in good fun, and they seem like pretty chill dudes. And they're just fun to watch ride around, and it's just fun listening to them talk about random stuff because of the way they talk about it. And their content is just interesting, it's good. They do new stuff, they have original, fresh ideas for vlogs, which is somewhat rare. Even my own channel, I think, is pretty stagnant and weak a lot of the time. The content might be interesting in some intellectual level, but it's not, like, fun. You know what I mean? I acknowledge that my own videos are boring a lot of the time. Maybe all the time, I don't know. But anyway, I've actually had some of my subscribers tell me that they would like to see me pair up with those big guys and do some dual vlog action. But honestly, I feel a little intimidated even asking them. Like, for one thing, I know how, you know, these are dudes with six-figure sub counts, right? They've got so much on their plate already, I feel like they don't need a small fish like myself coming along and kind of pestering them, like, hey, you want to go on a group ride with me? I'm Motor Merc. I've got like 600 subs and 10 people actually watching each video. The fact is, I would not even approach that from the perspective of trying to make a dual vlog out of it. I would just be interested to meet those guys, hang out with them, and have people to ride with, because it's just, I'm lonely. But anyway, regardless of whether or not I ever end up actually getting to ride with these dudes, I do admire them. I love watching their videos. And today I actually have nothing to do. It's my first genuine day off with no responsibilities that I've had in months. So I'm taking the opportunity to just ride around, and the original plan was to ride around completely aimlessly and just sort of wander and let my mind be free. What I ended up deciding to do instead was visit one of the holy meccas of motovlogging in Southern California, which is bakerXderek's mansion Hilltop. And I know a lot of other vloggers have actually gone there too, just to visit. And I know when bakerXderek meets up with people to do his dual vlogs, sometimes he meets up with them up there, so it's kind of become like this famous spot. So I'm thinking of this almost as like kind of a pilgrimage to a holy motovlogging site. Go there, pay my respects to the motovlogging gods. Oh. Gonna grab a burrito, kind of enjoy some lunch. Might possibly actually meet up with one of my subscribers today. This is a guy who's been following me for ages. Geez, probably years he's been following me. We've talked online a lot of times, and we've tried to get together to do a ride or to even just hang out and like do lunch or something, but it just has never worked out. But today might be the day. But in the meantime, I'm just gonna ride around and enjoy my damn self for a couple of hours. See if anything interesting happens along the way. It probably won't. Oh shoot, I didn't even know this was part of Route 66. I guess that's cool enough. I'm gonna actually GPS my way to the burrito spot, because I have no idea where I am right now and I'm getting real hungry. Come on, you thing. I'm loving this cell phone mount, by the way.
case you were wondering. Cell phone mounts are pretty awesome. I just got it. It is doing the job really nicely. I'm gonna have to pull over to do this properly. Now, I could just stop at any random burrito spot around here, but I need to make absolutely sure that I get the most delicious burrito possible, because I intend to make this a good day. Okay, let's see here. The burrito spot. This is part of the pilgrimage, by the way. This is a burrito spot that's been advertised by Mr. BXD himself. And I have been there before and enjoyed it. So I'm gonna hit this spot back up. Ricos Tacos de Jalisco. On Mount Vernon Avenue, it sounds right. One really nice thing about this phone, I hate this phone for so many reasons, but one thing that's really nice about it is for some reason, you can actually use it with motorcycle gloves. And I don't have any special, like,
follow the course of the road for 5 miles.
Got it. I don't actually have any of those, like, special threads on there that are supposed to make it possible for you to use the phone or a touchscreen with motorcycle gloves. It just works. Actually, I'm gonna tell it not to use highways because I do have so much damn free time on my hands.
Follow the course of the road for 17 miles.
Holy cow. 17 miles on one road? Oh, do not enter. All right. I can dig it.
I've been here before, but I don't remember when or why. Oh, that was years ago. I used to go to this bank years ago. When I used to go to, I was going to school to learn how to be a mechanic. I worked at BMW for a while, and I used to go to this bank when I went to school out here. They have one of the BMW factory training facilities out here in Rancho Cucamonga. Went to school out here for about a year and a half. Ended up working for BMW for about a year, and that was right smack in the middle of when the economy ate shit. So since I was pretty much one of the most recent hires there, I was one of the first ones to get laid off.
Which is fine. I ended up deciding that being a mechanic was probably not my calling in life anyway, which means all that schooling, it was a complete waste. But better that I had an exit, whether it was by my choosing or otherwise.
Because as stressful as computer science is, it is a whole lot better than slaving away, laboring on cars, I've got to tell you. But it may surprise you to learn that it doesn't pay better. A lot of the guys at the shop that I worked at, and all the shops that I worked at, have six-figure incomes because working on cars pays pretty good. Actually, you know what? Since we're in the area anyway, we might as well drop by my old school, see how it's doing, take a peek at it from the outside at least. Here we are, Haven Avenue. This is delaying my burrito, which I'm not happy about, but I'm happy about it for other reasons.
Nostalgia time. Nostalgia time. Yeah.
Oh, this is bringing back memories. Actually, while I was going to school here at Universal Technical Institute, was right around the time I started thinking about getting a motorcycle license, because my classmates in the BMW training course were
all talking about going and doing the training class together. I ended up not doing it with them. They went on ahead without me, but that was when the flame originally was kindled. And then I discovered M13, watched a few of his videos, particularly his famous biker wave video, and I also saw his videos on how to ride a motorcycle, and I just got inspired to go do it.
And that, my friends, was the beginning of Motomerc's motovlogging empire. Yeah, you run that red. Well, here we are. Universal Technical Institute. Somebody really should have reminded them when they were naming this place that there's another acronym UTI that's not as flattering. Oh, like I never left. A lot of people here today, actually.
Wonder what they're up to.
Nice bike, bro.
Yep, I used to drive here all the way from my house in western Los Angeles, 5 days a week, 150-mile round trip for a year and a half, and then I was, of course, paying the tuition to go here, and all that ended up amounting to nothing. Waste of time? Yes. I ended up getting my bachelor's degree in something that wasn't useful too, but I don't consider it a waste of time because I grew as a person and I learned a lot from my college experience getting that bachelor's. But this was an honest-to-God waste of time. Straight up. Anyway, that was a lovely little visit. I do have some good memories. Like, there was one class we had there that was like a performance tuning class, and we got to basically build T-bucket roadsters. We even had to build the parts. We had to build the engine. We built the Chevy 350s from parts. So the engine itself came to us as like nuts and bolts, and we had to build an engine out of it. And then we got to modify it and add parts, and then we put our little roadsters on the dyno. And I don't remember who won. Definitely not my team, because we weren't very good mechanics. Makes sense why I ended up not sticking with that career. But it was fun. And there were other things I got out of it too, I guess. Like, everything I know about electronics I learned here from automotive electronics courses, so I guess something came out of it, but not worth a year and a half of my life and all those tens of thousands of dollars of tuition. Oh shit! Monoprice!
So many coincidences on this ride today! Monoprice is a company where I buy all my cables and stuff online because they are super cheap and they have the best selection I have ever found. That's where I bought all of them. So I bought this cable for my phone, all the cables that hook up my camera for my bike, the power tethering and everything, it all came from Monoprice. And a lot of those cables I can't find anywhere else, even on like Amazon or eBay or whatever. Can't find some cables, like especially for this, for the drift, it uses a mini USB, not a micro USB, it's mini, which is a really old format, an old standard of cable, and it's hard to find those cables these days, especially if you want a particular length. You know, I don't need a 20-foot extension USB cable to plug my helmet into my jacket, which is only like 1 foot away. What is this? Road ends, son of a bitch. Why? Why? I don't think this particular bike is gonna do train tracks. Ugh. There's the openings in the gate, so I could go through, but I don't think I could get over the tracks safely. I should have known because I saw all the traffic from the road I was on was turning, and I was the only one who went straight, so there must have been a reason nobody else wanted to go this way. There it is. 10 more miles, but I'm hungry now! Gonna have to start splitting here. I need to get my burrito. First, I thought that truck pulled up to like help me out maybe and give me some shade because I noticed he moved just far enough to like put the shade of his truck over me. Then I looked up and he was making that face and I was like,
I try not to incorporate other vloggers' manner of speaking into my vlogs because I try not to steal those elements that make their channel good because for one thing I think it's mean to them. I mean, I know it's like a sign of flattery, right? Because you're saying I like your thing so much I want to use it too. And it's always tempting when I'm making a vlog to start saying bakerXderekisms and ArsonRides-isms. Choo! Yeah! But at the same time it also kind of feels like stealing. Done. Try.
After a quarter of a mile, turn right onto Northbound 3rd Avenue. Now turn right. After 1 mile, you will reach your destination.
for a little burrito time.
Well, that was a good burrito, I must say. I am glad I didn't stop at any old random burrito spot. This is a known entity, good entity. So now it's time to try and see if we can find our way to the famous Hilltop Mansion.
Time for a little piece of freeway action. Time for a little piece of freeway action. You can see it from here. How exciting. We're almost there. Oh no, right on red. Let me just back it up a spot.
The light here won't pick up my bike. I have to go do one of these U-turny things. Gonna have to flip a bit. Okay. Watch out for that water, or whatever substance it is. Step up to the edge here, catch a few of those famous bakerXderek V ropes, and I gotta say, they are some fine, high quality V ropes, even nicer than I expected. You really can't, I've said this before in other videos, but a view like this is really hard to appreciate on video. And here's the Hilltop Mansion itself. It's windy up here today.
Fourth?
Want to read it or ignore it?
Read it.
Did you want to read it or ignore it?
Read it.
It says, what city are you in? Reply, call back, or are you done?
Reply.
Alright, what would you like to say?
I'm at bakerXderek's Hilltop Mansion, north of San Bernardino.
Alright, so now I have, I'm at bakerXderek's Hilltop Mansion. North of San Bernardino. Send it, add more, or try again.
Send it.
Okay, I've sent that.
Thanks. But yeah, there it is in all its glory. This guy I was hanging out with was telling me he discovered this spot by bakerXderek's videos too, I guess. We started talking about how if you go back over the years and watch all of bakerXderek's videos of the Hilltop Mansion, you can see when it was first like under construction. And as you watch the videos, you can see how it grew and got nicer, and like now they've got a lawn and a fence and a driveway and everything. None of that stuff used to be there. It's crazy. You know, you learn stuff, you find spots, you get to see the development of things. when you follow vloggers for numbers of years. It's pretty cool. It's unreal being here, actually. It's pretty cool. And that's what kind of spot this is becoming, I guess. I mean, I hope it doesn't ruin it for the people who live here to have, like, if this becomes a thing where bikers are always coming up here to check out the Hilltop Mansion. They got a sign here now that says no parking anytime except by permit. Too bad. I guess this is as good a time as any to show off my Skyrim dragon that I've promised you guys multiple times I was going to show you. There's a 3D printer at work and some of the interns were taking requests, so I sent them a model for that. And I also got this little guy. My Castle Crashers dude. My little riding buddy.
Dance, glove, dance! Alright, that about does it for the mansion hilltop.
After 0.9 mile, turn right.
Or Hilltop Mansion. It really was cool seeing it. I'm glad I stopped and spent so much time here, because the other guy I'm supposed to meet up with today,
I was worried that he wasn't going to make it out, so I was just going to go home, but just while I was getting ready to leave, putting my helmet on and stuff, he ended up dropping me a text, so we're going to meet up after all.
So thirsty. I think I was dehydrated already when I left the house this morning, because I had some beer last night. May or may not have been hungover this morning, and all I had to eat today was a super salty but delicious burrito. So I'm sure, like, my body is crying out for moisture. Oh God. My motorcycle requires sustenance. Oh shit! That's the gas station!
After 0.2 mile, turn right onto East Ralston Avenue.
Excuse me.
So that ended up being a raging success. The hell is going on here? I met up as promised with my subscriber. He's a cool guy. He used to work at a motorcycle dealership, but no longer.